Hi friends, in this video we will talk about C# tutorials part 38 on stored processor. Keyword.net with store processor. Store processor maintains a collection of SQL statements. Store processor is a set of SQL commands which are compiled and are stored inside the database. Every time you create a SQL command, the command is faced, optimization is done, and then the command is executed. Facing and optimization, the command every time you run the query is very expensive. To solve this, we have a set of commands collectively called as store processors, which are already faced and optimized and executed whenever we call them. Comparing with functions and with the store processors improves the application. Here we discuss about how to use a store processor in AdWords.net. A store processor is a collection of SQL statements. Comparing with the functions, the store processors are very fast accessibility. The store processors can return collection values and stored in pre-executed block of code. It executes the first request only. The second request onwards, all requests communicates with the executed block for getting the output. Here is a syntax of a store processor. Here, at first, we have to declare the creation of store processor with a store processor name, and then the parameters are declared, and then we will begin the SQL statements and we end it. That's how we write a store processor. A store processor supports three types of parameters: in, out, and in out. The store processor maintains three parameter values and sends every parameter value in the parameter class. The parameter class is used to store one value from the store processor. After storing parameters in the parameter class, to set three values to each and every parameter. Parameter data types, parameter directions, and parameter value. Let's see how to create a store processor. For insert student, as I said before, we'll create a store processor where we declare the name of the store processor name is insert data. And then we will declare the parameters like son int, son varchar. You see, this is a parameter and this is the data type. For every time you use declare a parameter, you have to declare the data type, and then you have to begin the SQL command where you will insert the student, insert into the table name student with the parameter where S name and S values are the column names in the table where the values of S name and S one are used. Thus we create a store processor. For update student, similarly is the same process. Instead of insert, we will use update. You see, we have to updating the values. So we use this set here, the word set here, and we'll declare the values. For delete, you will use this same. where we declare the s1 name is equal to store name. Here is an example how to insert delete values in edu.net using a store processor. First take a form and add labels such as boxes and buttons. And here we will use the connection flow. At first we will create a connection and connection open and the command test, command type, parameter data types and parameter direction, parameter value and command execution, non-query and user interface. Here is an example about how in edu.net we will write for a parameter. At first we will declare the SQL connection and then we will declare the command and a parameter p and we will open the connection. Command text is equal to insert data. Command type is equal to insert type dot store processors, where we declare the parameters add p direction. We discussed before the how the flow goes. Similarly for s name as well, we will declare the values, parameter data types, where direction and values. Similarly we will declare for the s address and then we will send the SQL query. If you see the here the sp name, this store processor name has been declared, so it will be when we run it will follow the store processor name and it will do it. Here is for a parameter for update. You see here is how we create an update. Similarly for the above as we discussed before. This is how we create a store processor in edu.net without calling any in a without creating any store processor in SQL server. Now let's see how to add two numbers using a store processor. Here we take a form and then we will add labels and text boxes and a button and then create a store processor with a name, get value, where the parameters are declared. And we will use such a statement, this one. And in the source code, we will write this following code for the same. P parameter add p parameter in direction p value convert in direction so on, and then we will declare the execution non query. For more visitors on our website www.sirikd.blogspot.com and click now to subscribe our channel. And for more C# tutorials, click on the playlist below. And for more AngularJS tutorials, click on the playlist below. Thanks for watching our video. Have a nice day.